How difficult is it to get a fiance visa? It's pretty easy, let me tell you. There's a couple bare minimum requirements. I think you got to make 120% of poverty, which I think is like $22,000 a year. Can't have any felonies or anything like that. But if you're just kind of a normal, everyday, you know, Joe Blow that makes, you know, above $22,000 a year, doesn't have a criminal record, you're pretty much good to go. It's not a very hard process. It's just a bunch of paperwork and it's a little time consuming, that's all. So it's not difficult at all. I mean, the biggest thing that you need to know, the biggest thing, I'm gonna clap my hands right by the microphone so y'all wake up. The biggest thing you need to know is make sure the girl that you're interested in has never been married. There is zero divorce in the Philippines. If she has been married and that marriage was registered with the Philippine government, she will never be able to qualify for a fiance visa. One of the required documents for a fiance visa from the girl's aspect is what's called a CINMAR. It is a document that they have to get from the Philippine government certifying that they have never been married. If the girl does get an annulment, will she qualify for a fiance visa, or you're saying that she may still not be able to get a fiance visa even with the annulment? To my knowledge, if she has a legal annulment in the Philippines, which again is very hard to do, and from my understanding, don't quote me, you paying off a judge to get that one to happen. There's usually a fee involved to make that annulment happen. Basically, it's a payoff, I think. I've never had anyone try to do it, but I've heard some stories from, I've read stories on the internet about guys who tried to do it. I just don't think it's worth it. But yeah, if she's got the annulment and she's got the legal paperwork from the federal government, you know, with the stamp and everything, and it's legal, I would get it, ask her for a copy of it, and provide it to your immigration lawyer and have them verify that it is legal and that she is going to qualify and be eligible. Before you go any further, I would pay whatever fee the immigration lawyer is going to charge you to get that verification done, because once you start the process and make all the payments, it's non-refundable. So I would get that verification squared away right away, making sure that, you know, you it is going to work for you. Again, I don't know anyone that's actually tried it with a girl with an annulment. I just know that it's supposedly possible, but I'm not sure.
Search may be hopeless?
Check out our website at anewbride.com.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Then click on the notice bell to get notified every time we add something new.